Guess what? You don't need these amazing Photoshop skills to create an effective and highly clickable thumbnail for your YouTube videos. In today's video, I want to show you how to make a thumbnail on Canva, a free and very user-friendly design platform. So why do you want to make a good YouTube thumbnail? I mean, everyone's doing it, why not? But here's the thing, you may not know this, but YouTube actually measures something in your thumbnails to decide if your YouTube video is going to be successful or not. If you get this right, YouTube is gonna put your videos in front of more people and your channel could grow to the thousands, to the hundreds of thousands, so you wanna get this right. I'm gonna tell you how to do this, why it matters, and how to take advantage of this tool so that you can get more eyeballs on your content. And then I'll tell you everything you need to know about using Canva to create awesome YouTube thumbnails. So here's the thing that happens. When you create a YouTube video, YouTube will choose a randomly generated spot in your YouTube video to select as your thumbnail. And it could be like the weirdest thing. It could be you with your mouth hanging open. It could be an action shot where you have like just a blur. It could be something that doesn't actually portray what you're talking about in this video. And when you search for videos on YouTube, I'm sure that the design of the thumbnail is something that captures your attention, right? Usually it's the one that looks like some effort actually went into it. So if you want to grow your channel, I recommend you put this effort into it. But let me just ease any fears right now. You do not have to be a highly trained graphic designer because you have a tool that is at your fingertips. It is free and it can make you look like you paid a pro hundreds of dollars to be able to design this thumbnail for you, but you can do it for free and within minutes. YouTube, when deciding how successful your video is going to be, they measure your click-through rate. Of all the thumbnails that your audience will see when they search for the topic that your videos are they picking your thumbnail or other people's? So that click-through rate is really important to see that when people are searching, they're actually clicking onto your video. And it's measured by comparing how many people click on other videos compared to yours. Now, a good click-through rate is 4%. If you have more than 4% on your thumbnails, that's great. If you find that your thumbnails are getting less than 4%, I would play around with the design of your YouTube thumbnail. And I'll tell you what goes into a good YouTube thumbnail design. But I'll also tell you that you can use a tool called TubeBuddy, which I'll link in the description below, where you can split test your thumbnails. You can actually put up two different options for thumbnails, and it will test and show you after a specified period of time which thumbnail won, and you can decide which one you want to be the winning thumbnail for your video to attract more people to watch it. So let's get to the basics. When you're creating a YouTube thumbnail, how do you do it? Well, first of all, let me tell you, you have to get your channel verified, meaning YouTube just wants to know that you're not a robot. So just go to youtube.com/verify, be logged into your account, and it's gonna send an email or a text to your phone to just confirm, like I said, that you're not a robot. Very simple, takes seconds. Then the next thing is, well, let's design your thumbnail. Let's start with, what are the dimensions of a YouTube thumbnail? The dimensions of a YouTube thumbnail are 1280 by 720. And they can be uploaded to YouTube as a JPEG or a PNG. And I'll show you on Canva, they have tons of templates that you can use for your YouTube thumbnails. But before we get into that, I noticed you haven't subscribed to this channel yet. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, subscribe to this channel, because I'm putting out videos like this every single week to teach you how to grow your YouTube and scale your business. So let's go into Canva and I'm gonna search for YouTube thumbnail. And you'll see that, there it is, the 1280 by 720, the correct dimensions that we're looking for. And as you can see, there are tons of options here that we can be inspired by. We can actually use some of these exactly as they are. Maybe we just swap out what the picture is there with a picture of us or a picture of whatever the thing is that we're talking about. Maybe we want to change the colors to match our branding. As much as I love some of these pinks and yellows, my branding is gold and white and black. So I want to make sure that anything that I create is more in alignment with my branding. Now, before we actually go ahead and design our own thumbnail, let me point out what's consistent in all of these designs. What makes a good YouTube thumbnail? When you look at these examples, what stands out to you? To me, I see that the subject in every image is taking up about half of the image. They're really making the person make up most of the image because people connect to people and people want to see you as the person in the video. So whatever your thumbnail is, I would recommend having a big picture of you in it, and whether it's you smiling or whether it's you, you know, responding to whatever the topic of the video is, to capture that intrigue and curiosity and make you the friendly face of that video. In this video thumbnail, as you saw, I was making like a big crazy face of like, you know, here's my thumbnail, and that's why I want you to click on this so you can see it, you can learn from me, and learn by example. Look at my thumbnails. There's a ton of examples there how you can see where I'm, you know, being the face of the thumbnail. Maybe I'm pointing to the words. If I'm asking a question in the title of the video, maybe I'm doing some of these faces. So think about that for you and the thumbnails that you make to reflect the title of your video. You'll also see in a lot of these YouTube thumbnail templates, the title of the video or the topic of the video is laid out in this big text. Look at this total core workout that's taking up half of the thumbnail. One thing that I wouldn't recommend is having small text. So see here, this is a very tiny thumbnail and I can hardly read that says episode 3. You know, I can hardly read that. So know that when you're creating your thumbnail, yes, we want to have a big picture of you or whatever the subject is of the video. We want to have some big text, and it doesn't have to be the entire title of the video. Again, if you go to my YouTube channel, some of them don't even say the title of the video. Some of them might say something different that is also creating some sort of a captivating hook, still related to the title, but not using the exact title. The text on the thumbnail could be more hooky. It could create more curiosity than using the actual search engine optimized title. All in all, just make sure that the thumbnail isn't too busy. It's not too distracting. It's to the point. It aligns with your messaging and your branding, and that it's not deceiving. You know, sometimes on YouTube, people will talk about clickbait. And yes, we want to bait them that they'll click on it, but not in a way that it's clickbaity and deceiving that they're like, this isn't what I came here for. Because that can actually lose trust with your audience. And then you're going to have low watch time if they don't watch the video all the way through, which is going to hurt your ranking and your authority on YouTube. So if I were to design a thumbnail based on one of these templates, maybe I'll just choose this one just to be easy. It stood out to me. I love the colors. I love the design of it. What I would do is I would pretty much keep the same layout, but I would just replace the words, the imaging, and the colors with my own. So I can go into my uploads and maybe I drag one of my pictures into here. I'm going to expand it all the way across. I'm going to move it more into place. I'm going to position it backwards so that I can get those cool designs back in place. And now seeing how that lays out, maybe I'm going to move that picture, make me a little bit bigger, and I'll change this color to be more of my branding color. So I use a lot of gold and black and white. Cool. And then I might change this to be whatever the title of my video is. So voila. See how me designing that thumbnail literally took me 30 seconds. I didn't have to start from scratch. I didn't have to rack my brain thinking, how am I going to design this? I took what Canva had as a template. I switched out the colors for mine. I switched out the text for mine. And I switched out the picture for one of me. Look how easy that was. I hope you try it out. Canva is amazing. It's free. You can use the paid version, but everything I did right there is using all the free functionality that you would ever need. If you want to learn more about creating content that converts into cash flow, I have just the training for you. If you click the link below, you can get access to that today for free. I will see you on the next video.